The 2K Sports Pregame Show, sponsored by Kia.
Greetings and welcome to 2K Sports. I rarely say greetings, but I just did. I'm your host, Ernie Johnson, alongside Kenny and Shaq. In a few moments, we'll be sending you out to Indianapolis as the Pacers go up against the Chicago Bulls. Looking at the Bulls, their performance at the beginning of this season has been sensational. They're obviously a very talented team, and their effort level has matched their talent level night in and night out. They're playing with some serious intensity here in the early part of the schedule. And we'll get to see Paul George in this one. Obviously, we saw the terrible leg injury he suffered, but he has done more than just come back. In some ways, he's come back better than ever, hasn't he, Kenny?
Yeah, that's impossible almost. I mean, you think about the horrific scare that we all had watching him go down, and he's taken his game to another level, taking central control of the offense, and now he plays incredible defense. How do you do that, Shaq? How does a guy have that kind of injury and be able to come back with that kind of confidence?
Well, it's called heart. The guy has a big heart. And not only that, Kenny, you can respect this as a shooter. His improvement in the three-point shot has been a game changer for him. He's clearly one of the elite talents in the league right now after that injury. I'm happy for him.
Love that Paul George story. Time now for tip-off. Kevin Harlan's got the call.
Welcome, everyone, to Indianapolis, Indiana. It's the home of the Pacers, where we will be broadcasting today's action live. This is Kevin Harlan, joined by Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and on the sideline, David Aldridge. Pacers trying to take advantage of their home court in this one before leaving Indiana. Some doubts forming early for these guys. They've gone 0-4 to start the season. They need a win, fellas.
This is a special matchup. I mean, we got here tonight two rival franchises, a lot of history between the two, yeah, and some bad blood. So let's just see how all this adds up in terms of drama.
You know what? This game has been circled on every NBA fan's calendar for a while now. Can't wait to see what unfolds here.
We are nearly ready for the tip-off, but first, let's hear from our very own David Aldridge. DA, it's all yours.
Thank you, Kevin. Guys, Chicago is one of the league's biggest markets, but it still has that blue-collar culture. Longtime Bull Lowell Deng exemplified that spirit. He said, if you're coming in to just show your skills, just look good, the city of Chicago is not going to accept you. They want to see you work hard night in and night out. If you do, the city will love you. Kevin?
They want grit and toughness, David. Thank you. We'll get a chance to see two very stout defensive teams here, Steve. Points are going to be hard to come by.
Yeah, you're going to have to find a way to get some easy buckets. But both these teams, they take away your first and second options. Little things like offensive rebounds, second chance points might make the difference.
They make you pay, though, don't they?
Huh? Yes, indeed.
Buyer beware or driver beware. All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. So for Chicago right now, Rajon Rondo is out there with Dwayne Wade. Then there's Jimmy Butler. Then it's Taj Gibson. And it's Lopez in at the five spot. Now here's Rondo. Paul George unable to get his shot to go. And the dunk by Lopez.
Obviously, Rondo's main priority is to dish the rock. When you're open, he'll get it to you.
Now here's Ellis. Turner with a screen on Wade. Ellis wide open. A three-pointer off the mark. Indiana on D. This game coming after a loss against the Bucks.
You know what? A lot of three-pointers, but for me more so, it was the shot selection on those three-pointers. I just felt like they were just too trigger-happy from downtown.
They weren't patient enough to try to find the most wide-open shot on every three-pointer. That's why they missed so many.
Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
And last season, Paul George, getting back to the All-Star game, I mean, well documented, going through that awful compound fracture in his leg, and said that that All-Star appearance was the most meaningful one of his career. And one of my favorite players and people in our game. It's just really great to see him back and playing at such a high level.
No good on that one. And the Pacers asking George to play more power forward last season. He was a little apprehensive, I think, Greg, initially, especially coming off that injury.
Yeah, and he ended up mostly guarding on the wing. They let C.J. Miles do the dirty work on the block, but the extra space afforded by their spread-out attack allowed him to flourish at the offensive end.
And he sinks the second. Well, there was a concern that in the post-Thibodeau era, the Bulls' defense would see a sharp decline. But they still played rugged, tough defense.
Well, if you have great individual defenders, you're still going to be a good defensive team. Yes, we talked about Tibbs and the Bulls era. It was all about defense. This team is able to do both.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that.
Teague against Rondo. Teague kicks to George. That doesn't go either for George. Bulls have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. Wade. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it 3.
His whole career, Wade has been making shots like that through contact. Great stuff.
And the return of Wade to his hometown Chicago Bulls, Greg. One of the major stories, certainly, in free agency.
Yeah, I mean, he had bigger offers on the table, but said the only real options for him were Miami or Chicago. And for a Bulls team that seemed on the verge of a rebuild, getting Wade has given them a fighting chance now in the East.
Now here's Teague. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against the Bucks in Milwaukee.
And he wreaked havoc on defense with 4 steals for the game. I have no clue how he got that shot to fall, but I'm sure he'll take it.
Wade dishes to Rondo.
Hey, who got ball? Who got ball?
Back to Wade. Jacks up a 3. Thaddeus Young grabs the miss. Indiana's gone 0-2 from deep here. Teague the pass to Ellis. And there's the 3-second call, this one on the defense. The Pacers shooting their 3rd free throw attempt of the game.
And going back a season ago, they were a pretty average team at the line, about 76% altogether.
And the technical free throw is good. Here's Teague. Just over 2.5 minutes played here so far in the first quarter. Tough sequence there. They just couldn't get it to fall. Wade kicks to Gibson. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. At the top of the key, Lopez. To the middle. Wade can't hit.
Look, he's doing everything he can to get out of this funk. Just been a rough quarter. Shooting the basketball.
And once again off the mark by Indiana.
Mix up defensively left him wide open from mid-range. That's a shot he needs to hit.
Basket counts.
Butler is a proven scorer. You give him the ball in the paint and he'll find a way to get it done.
Pacers trail by 3. And first quarter, we're about 3.5 minutes in. Teague dishes to George. Shoots a 3. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. George has got 5 points so far.
He is very frustrating to guard because he makes plays that will drive you crazy.
Rondo with the ball. An 11-point game for him in the win against New York. Here's Wade. Thaddeus Young grabs the miss.
And he's clearly just disappeared here this quarter, not making any contributions here with his offense.
You know, offense is about rhythm. He has lacked rhythm in this entire quarter.
Man, he's got such a great touch and feel around the basket. He made that reverse look easy.
Rondo kicks to Wade. Turner with the steal. Young outside, and it's Rajon Rondo with the foul. That's his first foul.
And you can see he just didn't get squared up with his feet.
And so it's Indiana with it. Shots good from Young.
He has definitely found his rhythm knocking down the mid-range shots the D has given him.
Bulls trail by four. Rondo on top. Teague covering. To halt the run. Wade. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play.
Wade is 6'4", but when he gets it down by the rim, he might as well be 7 feet. There's just no stopping him.
And you look over the career of Dwayne Wade. He was initially a slasher, but he's improved his shot and pull-up jumper immensely. And even has become a threat from deep if you give him space.
Thinking again about how Wade's skills have evolved over the years, his offensive game has grown immensely since his rookie season.
And it's why he will go down as one of the all-time greats. His work ethic in improving his game. Fantastic post-up player as a guard. Wade's ability to score in any fashion is what makes him one of the great closers in our game.
When Lopez gets in that close, it's tough to stop him from slamming it home.
Indiana's gone just 1-4 from three-point range here in the first. Teague the pass to Ellis. The dish to George. And too long on the shot.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's going to buy himself a ticket to the bench if he keeps shooting it like that. He has been putrid here this quarter.
Butler dishes to Rondo. Passed away. He feeds it to Gibson. Back to Wade. Down to five on the shot clock. Took the opportunity when he saw it. Wade's got 8 points.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought. Without any individual agendas.
Teague against Wade. Will it go? Teague can't hit.
Not the best shot right there with a good defender draped all over you?
No, not at all. When you see him guard you, just try to move the basketball on.
And they've had assists now in their last three baskets. Well, after the Bulls said goodbye to Derrick Rose, you knew they were going to be in the market for a point guard. And Rajon Rondo stepped right in, and although not a direct replacement for what Rose brings, still a very strong signing. They could have done a lot worse when it comes to filling in that lead guard role.
Dwayne Wade at the stripe. How many times have we said that before? He lives there.
T kicks to George. Back to Teague. And it goes out of bounds. That one off Butler.
And let's check out the stats for Rondo. Last season, he played outstanding. First in assists. And, of course, he's got a nose for the ball. He ranked in the top 10 in steals last season.
So, timeout called here, the first for Indiana. There are a lot of great coaches known for their defensive prowess. And, Steve, do you have your pick for the best defensive coaches in the NBA right now?
Greg Popovich does a nice job. Rick Carlisle comes to mind. These guys just does a nice job of being able to change their defensive philosophy throughout the course of the game. Doc Rivers also come to mind, being able to play with what he has, and he can change up on the fly.
Knocks it loose. George uses the glass to finish the layup. George has got 7 points.
With that now, only 2 of 7 to start the game. Not the start he was hoping for.
And the pass to Gibson. Wade outside. and Gibson wide open. He shoots. Lopez. And the dunk by Lopez.
You love the way Robin Lopez just goes after those missed shots. That's where he can do damage.
Butler against George. To the inside. And Turner with the basket on the assist by George. Turner's got his second basket of the game.
He delivered that pass right on the spot to his teammate who was on the move.
Outside, Rondo feeds it to Lopez. Rondo passes to Gibson. 9 feet out. It's good. He's got eight.
Oh, this is the kind of start they were hoping for.
Pacers trail by six. T kicks to Turner. Ellis left side. Outside Butler. He doesn't hit that one. And Indiana will go the other way with it.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin. Particularly here to start the game.
Ellis dishes to George. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. It's on Jimmy Butler.
Yeah, easy call.
The Pacers shooting their fourth and fifth shots at the foul line in the game.
Two shots.
That free throw good from George. Well, for the Pacers last season, they trade Roy Hibbert to the Los Angeles Lakers. David West took far less money. Greg to leave town. You worried about their front court and that it would be in shambles?
Yeah, and instead, a rookie Miles Turner showed himself to be a steal as a shot-blocking, perimeter-shooting big. And it was a best-case scenario. If they could build on that, I think they have a chance to be one of the contenders in that Eastern Conference.
The one thing the Bulls can hang their hat on is rebounding. They've always been one of the best rebounding teams in this league. Last season was no different for them.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Miles, that's good.
And a nice job here early of establishing an inside presence.
So at Chicago now, the Pacers making the shot. Carter Williams, the pass to Portis. Grant outside. Top Carter Williams, the 19-foot shot, and that one good. And the Bulls lead by seven. And the Bulls were third in the NBA in rebounding last season. They are just so good, Steve, at closing out possessions on the defensive end.
Yeah, you said it best. Defensively, they do a nice job. But when you start talking about defense, you got to finish it with a rebound. They thrive in rebounding the basketball. They have guys at every position that want to get their hands dirty.
LaVoy Allen's checked in for George. And the Bulls with possession. They're on an 18-7 run. Carter Williams kicks to Grant. Pass to Mirotić. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. It's on Al Jefferson. And we knew that Mirotić could shoot, but he showed a lot more consistency, Steve, last season from deep. Saw his big jump in that three-point percentage column.
Mirotić can definitely shoot the basketball, and we know that he's going to be a threat for his team. Shooting it deeper and deeper, what the good thing for him is his percentage is starting to go up. I think for him is to limit some of the off-balance shots and some of those shots that are so deep that you just can't shoot a high percentage.
First one falls for
Mirotić, a big man with range for days. His skill set fits in well with this team.
So Mirotić nails both of them. Well, for so long, you always heard the old saying, you live by the three, you die by the three. Team shooting more three-point shots now, Smitty, than ever. Is it time to retire that cliche and say, you know, well, it's part of the game. That's a standard in the game.
You know, Kevin, no. I think the Warriors just have an asterisk. That's it.
Because
they won the championship.
So good.
They won the championship. Yeah. And if they keep winning, you'll keep saying Warriors.
But if you don't win a championship, yes, you keep shooting the three ball, but you might want to find a way to hit some twos because everybody can't shoot it like the Warriors.
Oh, inflicting some punishment with the two-hand flush.
They're going for the throat. It's Brooks on the wing. He's covered by Grant. Nice shot by Brooks.
He knew what he wanted to do all along. The teardrop.
The Bulls leading by 7. And here is Grant. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. For Chicago, they haven't yet missed a free throw. 5 for 5. Drops for Carter Williams.
And the Pacers really for so long kind of defined that old school plotting defensive oriented team, and then they just flipped the script last season. I mean, completely reinventing themselves, playing much of that season with 4 perimeter players on the court and finding ways to be successful at doing it.
And the Pacers had great success in the past, but they just felt they couldn't score enough with the two big men clogging up the middle.
Yeah, and the crazy thing is that even going smaller, they were still a top 5 defensive team. They found some big men who can shoot from the perimeter now, and what you like is that they have flexibility in terms of their style of play.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Grant kicks to Portis. And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession. And where have the shots been coming from tonight? Here's a look. Broken down by paint, mid-range, and 3-point shot attempts so far for Indiana.
And really, there's just such a lack of scoring for them from out at the top of the arc in terms of 3-point range. And in today's game, you have to get scoring from the 3-point range. And that area out above the free throw line extended is a real weak spot for them so far.
Mirotić and Allen with the block.
And despite that miss, a strong start for them offensively.
Back to Brooks. Here's Stuckey. And he didn't get quite enough under that one. The Bulls leading by 7. Here's Carter Williams. Good work defensively by Stuckey.
Worked it inside. Normally an easy basket for him, but just a little out of rhythm on the release.
And it goes down 2 points.
How about the way he's able to angle his body to shield the big fella off and still get the finish?
Well, he has to be able to use angles. He has to be a great finisher in tight spaces and to be able to throw his little body into the big guys.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
Solid work at the line a season ago. 83% on his opportunities.
Free throw, good, Stuckey.
And one of the more aggressive teams in the league this past offseason, looking to adjust their roster, the Indiana Pacers. I mean, the trade for Jeff Teague, another for Thaddeus Young, the signing of Al Jefferson. It's going to be interesting to see how all these new players gel in Nate McMillan's system.
Pacers trail by 6. Allen, a screen on Carter Williams. Stuckey dishes to Brooks. Screen by Jefferson. Allen, right side, tries from 16. No good off the back of the rim.
You love the closeout on that possession.
I love it because you don't give up on the play. Just that little contest bothered his shot.
And stolen by Mirotić. Puts up a 3. Sinks the 3-pointer. And now it's a 9-point Chicago lead. Now Brooks. Allen, a screen on Grant. From deep, Brooks. And the release was before the buzzer, but it's off target.
Remarkable hustle from Mirotić on defense. Shooters don't feel comfortable when he's around.
Oh, we've seen some great shots in the first quarter. No shortage of offense. Bulls lead by 9. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Indianapolis. And talk to Monte Ellis. He says he feeds off his doubters. He loves to hear someone say what he can't do.
I think I had that all my life. I always had to prove somebody wrong. And, you know, still to this day. That's just the competitiveness that I believe my oldest brother built into me when I was little.
And that kind of relentless determination is something Monte is known for. And one of the reasons he's been around for a decade in the NBA as a consistently good player.
And welcome back. It's been all one-sided so far through the first quarter as our second quarter gets underway. And taking a look at Chicago's performance here, guys, what have they been doing or not doing?
They come out the gates here strong and put together just a solid first quarter.
And that's exactly how you want to start this one off. They open this one up with a real bang.
On the court right now, second quarter for the Bulls. McDermott and Mirotić, the sharp shooting forwards. Carter Williams is out there with Grant. And it's Portis in at the pivot spot, manning the middle.
Huge hole in the defense that possession. He didn't waste any time cutting through it.
Here's Mirotić. And a great assist by Carter Williams as that one goes in. Mirotić has got the lead back up to 9 now for the Bulls. Screen by Jefferson. Stuckey passes to Brooks. Allen, a screen on Grant. Again, the miss by Brooks.
And if the shot's not there, you've got to understand that. Move the basketball.
Those types of shots are low quality. You're not going to win too many friends on that one.
Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Well, guys, in the era of 3-and-D and 4-out-and-1-in, some say the post-up is a lost art. That makes Al Jefferson a throwback player. He said it happened right in front of my eyes. When I came into the league, it was still a big man's game. Everything changed around me. I've always been a back-to-the-basket, post-move player. I just stuck to what I do best, guys.
Yeah, and I hope he never changes. Thanks, D.A. Pacers trail by 12. And the wide-open shot from Stuckey. And the miss, not the best shot selection there. The Bulls have gone 2-of-3 from the field here to open the second quarter. Grant gets a wide-open look. And again, it's the Bulls from deep.
Yeah, those are starting to add up, guys. Of their last 5 baskets, 3 have been triples.
Stuckey kicks to Allen, looking to end the run. And the layup is up and in. Allen's got his first basket of the night.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Dishes to Mirotić. Good ball movement here by the Bulls. Miles, the pass to Allen. Got a piece of it. And it's Grant in the corner. The Bulls keep it alive. Here's Portis, defended by Jefferson. Portis kicks to Carter Williams. McDermott for 3, and a great assist by Carter Williams as that one goes in. Carter Williams has got 4 assists now tonight. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Start it.
Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over. And what a breakout year it was for Doug McDermott in 2016. Saw a lot more time on the floor, and he earned it with better production, Steve, in every facet of his game.
Yeah, I think the breakout year for him is on the defensive end, and also the game. As a youngster, it's hard to come into a team that good. But I think for Doug McDermott, being able to shoot the basketball but also being able to defend is the reason why he's got more time, and that's why he looks better.
So Indiana ends up with a new group on the floor. Now about 3 minutes gone in the second quarter of basketball.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
Here's Lopez, back to Wade, and right on through for another basket. He's got 5 made on 5 of 9 shooting.
If you let Wade get the ball that deep, there really isn't anything you can do.
Now here's Teague. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. Turner with a screen on Rondo. Teague. And it's Chicago with the rebound. Gibson's got 4 rebounds in this game. Three-pointer, Butler. Jeff Teague with the rebound. Pacers trail by 18. For the three. The offensive rebound. Shots good from Young. Young's got his second basket of the night. Here is Rondo. There's the feed to Lopez. To the paint. Here's Butler. And it's sent back by Turner. Gibson dishes to Wade. Shot clock at 6. Second shot opportunity. Pacers with the rebound. Young's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. Shot from 16. George, no good.
Look, that's in his range, but he had a defender right up in his chest.
Wade passes to Gibson. That falls. Nice feed that time from Dwayne Wade. And the Bulls lead by 18. Indiana's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Now here's Ellis. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Milwaukee.
Hey, but it didn't deter him from attacking defensively. His pressure was terrific. He also got 3 steals in that game.
And an impressive rookie season for Miles Turner, Greg. A bit of a slow start after requiring thumb surgery, but once he got out on the floor, he gave signs that he can be the Pacers' pivot of the future.
A millennial big man.
Yes.
Really, he's got the shot blocking and the ability to shoot it deep. Those kinds of players are really rare. Big time upside. They did very well for themselves with that number 11 pick.
Pacers trail by 15. Ellis kicks to Young, and the shot is good. Young's got 6 points.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Well, Chicago has gone 3 of 5 beyond the arc since the start of the second quarter. Passes it to Lopez. They get a hand on it. Butler against George. Butler dishes to Lopez. Goes up at the stripe. Tries again. So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and 2 shots coming up.
And Lopez doing whatever he can to get himself to the line.
And with Chicago and the Bulls, it seems that no matter what the current team does, they'll always be playing in the shadow of his Aaroness, Michael Jordan.
Tough act to follow when you're talking about the Michael Jordan Chicago Bulls. Every great player that Bulls have, they get compared to Michael Jordan. That's just not fair.
Steve, you know, you won a handful of gold medals with the U.S. national team, and then the program went into a period of decline. Now they're back. How did they get back on track?
You know what, Kevin? I can go back to 2000, where we almost lost that gold medal. And I think you just can't throw all-stars together and expect to have team chemistry. Mm. They did a nice job of bringing back the training camp kind of atmosphere. Continuity, what you need to have a winning, successful program.
Now, here's Teague. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. And George with the stuff.
Oh, that's great. TNT, baby. Explosive.
That was pretty. And he just has that effortless knack for getting inside. Here's Rondo following the score by Indiana. Gibson passes to Rondo to the middle. Puts it up from 12. And good. Got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim. He's got 12.
He's been on target all night, and that's helped the whole team.
Timeout
call, the Pacers.
Start it.
And Rajon Rondo, really one of the purest point guards over the last decade when you're talking about assists. I mean, he's a guy with the ball in his hands is very effective at making decisions for the offense, dictating pace. And when he plays off the ball, especially as a spot-up shooter, that's when problems can arise, but he knows how to move without the ball and always seems to find himself in the right place at the right time.
And for Rondo, somewhat of a resurgence last season, gained back much of the confidence he had lost after his tumultuous time in Dallas.
Yeah, I felt like Rondo felt appreciated last year, and there's no substitute for having the support of your team. This is a proud individual, and we're talking about a big-time game.
See, that's a good look from within his range. You know he's kicking himself for missing it.
and it's Wade in the corner, stolen by Ellis. Here's Young. And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
Shooting one.
He is just getting hotter as the game goes along, building on a strong start. He's absolutely crushing it here in the second quarter.
And for Thaddeus Young, extremely effective last season after signing a four-year, $50 million contract. Definitely made an effort to earn that money.
And for a guy who didn't operate much out of the post, he still took high percentage shots. You saw the hustle, his ability to rack up steals, the improved rebounding. He moves his feet well enough to play the three and worked on his strength enough to where he can also play the four.
And for Jimmy Butler, for a player with his skill set, he sure heard his name floated around a lot in the rumor mill, Steve. Interesting to see a team want to trade someone with his talent.
Yeah, you do, because of some of the disagreements he's had with his coaching staff. But, you know, bottom line, Jimmy Butler is an all-star, a guy that's one of the best two-way players in this game. You're not going to trade him for just nothing, so I don't see him going anywhere.
No wasted trips at all. They're taking care of business at the line.
Pacers trail by 15. Screened by Young. Ellis kicks to Young. Young sets a screen for George. Back to Young. Tries to save it. And Gibson sends it down.
Gibson is in there to get dirty on defense. His shot blocking is exceptional. Can't be careless around him.
Four on the clock. Indiana needs to get a shot off. They get it back. Young.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
Wade kicks to Butler. Looking for Gibson. He gets it there. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two. And last season, Taj Gibson dealing with his name being on the trading block for a good portion of the time. Steve, seemed like it was finally his chance to break out and put up big numbers, too.
Well, you see Taj Gibson's ability to play above the rim. Defensively, he is solid. You were waiting for his offensive game to catch up to everything. He's not there yet, but he's one of those guys that's a terrific contributor on the team, and you got to have him. Taj Gibson's one of those players that's just always in the right place at the right time, never plays outside himself on either end. He just gives you effort every time out.
And he misses the second one as well, so he is 0 for 2 that time. And with Gibson, you like that he can play as a starter or come off the bench. He's effective in both. He's comfortable in either role as he's done both, Steve, for extended periods of time.
Because his mindset, whether starting or coming off the bench, is to play with energy, effort, and to defend. So any role, starter or off the bench, he thrives.
Pacers trail by 15. Right side Teague. Here's Turner. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Wow. He got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
And this will be his second and third shots at the line here.
In their last contest, guys, he was unconscious from the foul line.
Take a break. Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one.
And getting to the line and hitting your free throws, a good way to get back into the game. It stops the clock and extends the game and allows you the opportunity to set your defense. They've been perfect from the line so far here in the second quarter.
Both free throws good from Turner.
And good job they're doing at the line this quarter. They'll need to continue converting those free throws.
Rondo on top, Teague covering, and out of bounds as the Pacers gain possession.
And checking out the numbers for Lopez. Good season for him last year. Ninth in field goal percentage and a top 15 ranking in blocks per game, supplying that backline protection that is so key to a great defense.
Ellis kicks to Young. Young, a screen on Rondo. It's George on the wing, defended by Butler. It's deflected, and it goes out of bounds. That one off Gibson. And here is the shot chart as we see how things are going.
Well, they haven't really been strong enough inside. I mean, they haven't been a force or aggressive with getting those good quality looks in the paint. And I think the one-dimensionality of their offense is going to continue to be an issue because the defense isn't having to worry about clogging the lane or defending down low.
And that'll be Indiana as it goes out of bounds. Pacers retain possession.
Yeah, that's a super defensive play. If that gets through, no doubt they score.
Absolutely. Prevented an easy bucket. Fantastic D.
Now, here is Young. 9 points in the game so far.
Whenever Gibson is nearby, shooters are going to think twice. Just an incredible defensive player with a great feel for the game. Really bad mental lapse by the defense, yet he did not make them pay, surprisingly.
And stolen by Butler. Rondo with a clean look. The three-pointer off the mark. Pacers trail by 13. Nobody near George. And the Pacers can't get it to go.
He hit 1-3 in the first, but the well has been totally dry for him in the second.
Butler, no good.
And this is why you need good defenders on the interior to contest shots.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a whole different ball game down low when this fella's lurking around. There was no defense present there whatsoever. Anyone could have made that wide open shot.
Lopez against Turner. That's tipped. Now here's Rondo. Tight defense on him. Blanketed by the D. He fights to the rim for the layup.
Really admire the fact that Rondo is not afraid to go down there in the paint from time to time.
Kicks to T. Screened by Young. The dish to Turner. 6 on the shot clock. Tries again. And the layup is good. Turner's got 11. And the first timeout of the game called for Chicago.
Take a look at the Bulls roster now. A lot of young talent versus veterans they had in the past. Not a lot of these guys you see as superstars, but I think a lot of them will be starters in their careers.
Both teams deciding to change it up. The Bulls leading by 10.
You got him.
Grant outside. They set the screen. Pacers with the rebound. Victory eluded them last time in Chicago when they faced the Bulls.
And that was an ugly loss for them last time playing these guys. And really, the rebounding differential was the key.
They demonstrate a real tenacity on the glass and made their presence felt. We'll see if they can repeat that kind of play.
The lead now in single digits. 7 points for Stuckey. Chicago's gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here. Shot from 16. No good from Grant. And there's the foul. It'll go on Jaren Grant. That's his first foul. Pacers trail by 8. 1:29 left here in the second. Jefferson, a screen on Grant. Here's Brooks, and he finishes nicely on the way. He's got 6.
You've got to give a ton of credit to the screener. That play easily opened up the easy layup for his teammate.
Grant outside. Pass to Fortis. Back to Grant. Second chance shot, and he lays it up and in. Grant's got 5 points now in the quarter.
And that putback about as easy a bucket as you're going to get.
And you can see one team is working hard on the glass and the other not.
Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here. Let's take a look at the 2K leaderboard to find out who were the best shooters from behind the arc last season. 5th best, Doug McDermott.
The bucket must have looked 3 feet wide to him last year. I mean, very deserving in terms of that spot among the league leaders from 3.
Two shots.
The first free throw is good. He hits one and misses one, each at the line.
A slight advantage for them in the rebound department, but that oftentimes is all it takes.
Carter Williams dishes to Mirotić. Carter Williams, the pass to McDermott. They get a bet, and there's the foul. It'll go on Nikola Mirotić. That's his first foul of the game, and the bonus will go to the free throw line. Pacers have been shooting right around 75% at the line, 9 of 12 so far. And the first one at the line is good. Both free throws good from Al Jefferson. We've got 28 seconds left in the second quarter. Grant outside. And Mirotić kicks to McDermott. That one falls, his second basket of the game. He's now 2 for 3.
Doug McDermott is not just an outside shooter. He has a nice touch inside as well.
Screen by Jefferson. Brooks dishes to Stuckey. From deep three-point range, and it would have counted had it fallen, but it's offline. And so we wrap up the first half. It's the Bulls leading by 7. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks. Dwayne, how did you evaluate the first half?
I like the way we started the game. You know, sometime on the road we start off slow, so I thought we got to the fight early. And it's our two good teams, so, you know, it's the way it should be.
Yeah, we'll see if you can keep their crowd out of it in the second half. Thanks, Dwayne. Back to you, Kevin.
Okay, David, much appreciated. And now time for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Ernie Johnson, joined by Kenny Smith, right there. And Shaquille O'Neal, he's right there. Welcome to the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. Dwayne Wade wasted no time getting hot. He had 13 points and 1 assist. And Shaq, what did you see out there from the Bulls?
Well, they've been playing with some toughness, and it's led to a nice lead for them, not just on the scoreboard, but in the rebounding numbers. And now they need to stay mean, Ernie. You cannot lose that edge in the second half.
And Kenny, let's get your input on the Pacers.
Their inaccuracy from behind the arc was brutal. Shot selection, I didn't see any. The perimeter offense they're running, you could scrap that. They need to get back to the basics. Pound it inside, more pick and roll. Try to pick up some easy buckets in transition.
And that wraps up halftime as the game is set to get back underway. Let's send it back to Kevin Harlan and crew. They are standing by courtside.
Downtown Indianapolis glowing in the distance as we welcome you back to the action here at Bankers Life Fieldhouse. And the second half about to start here in just a few moments. Dwayne Wade really has his fingerprints all over this one.
And he just went off in those first two quarters, guys. He's capable of doing that on a consistent basis as well. So we might see some changes from a defensive standpoint as they try to disrupt his rhythm in the second half.
Yeah, the change has to be double-teaming him. Single coverage will not get it done.
Last outing for Chicago, they won that game against New York.
They just weren't challenged. I mean, nearly as much as they should have been in that game, at least when they had the ball.
Their offense came fairly easy to them out there. The D wasn't rushing them to do anything, and because of that, they made a lot of smart, calculated decisions that turned into easy points.
Monte and George filling out the perimeter. Young and Turner up front, and it's Teague in at the one spot. They're the group for Nate McMillan starting the second half. Steve, when you watch Jimmy Butler play, you have to pay attention at all times. He can just explode on a moment's notice and completely take over a game.
I just love Jimmy Butler on the offensive end. He came into this league known as a defender, hard work. But when no Derrick Rose, he turned into a guy that can score the basketball and is counted on that end.
So he hits both.
Fred Hoiberg with the Bulls. Still on his learning curve. Coming from the college game to the pro, he still has some adjustments to go.
Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Well, guys, it was controversial in Chicago, but the Bulls hired Fred Hoiberg to replace Tom Thibodeau. Hoiberg played for a decade in the NBA, and at Iowa State, he was the fastest coach in school history to reach 100 wins. In Chicago, guys, it seems he's loosened the reins a bit, giving the players a little more leeway to shoot with confidence and air it out offensively.
The players have responded. Thanks, David. Here's Teague. After the made shot from Dwayne Wade, Young, a screen on Butler. And George kicks to Ellis. No good from outside. And for Hoiberg, I think the Bulls know, Steve, that he'll have a bit of a learning curve as this is his first time as a head coach in the NBA.
Yeah, I mean, when you start looking at the NBA, they want you to win now. But for Fred Hoiberg, it is a learning curve. And last year, I thought, was a learning curve for Hoiberg. This year should be better.
Now, here's George. After Dwayne Wade's miss, it's good.
That's the shot they were looking for. After three straight misses coming out of the break, let's see if that sparks a rally.
George, no good on the free throw. The Bulls leading by nine. Rondo kicks to Butler. Gibson passes to Butler.
Don't let him shoot that.
He tries for three. And the Bulls with another miss. Indiana's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Teague with a clean look. Bangs home the trifecta. Teague's got himself going there. His first points of the game in the deep ball. For Chicago, they've gone 1-3 since starting the second half. Rondo kicks to Lopez. Butler against George. Turner with the steal. And now here's George, the fast break opportunity. And George with the stuff.
It's as if the defense just let him go.
I think, you know what? He sniffed out the opportunity on the break. That's called cherry picking.
Here's Butler. It's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
And let's take a look now at some stats for Ellis. Some last season stats for him. He was around 14 points a game last year. Four assists and three rebounds. And every team in the league needs shooting. That's what he brings coming off the pine.
Shooting two.
The free throw drops for Butler.
I think Jimmy Butler is top of my list as far as two-way players that can do just about anything you ask him.
He's perfect from the line this time. Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. There's the pick. Outside Teague. Here's Turner. That one's not going to go. And in Chicago the other way.
And hard work on the glass once again, guys. And they put a lot of effort and focus on the backboard.
Here's Ellis. And it's Wade with the rebound.
Even though he couldn't quite convert the layup, I like him being in attack mode.
Here's Rondo. Great D that time from T.
They've struggled so far here in the third, hitting just 1 of 4 from the field.
It's stolen by Wade. down low. Here's Rondo, and a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
Rondo is so tricky. Consistently looking to take advantage of the defense being too physical with him.
This is his first free throw of the game.
And not the guy you want to see at the line too often. Season numbers has him in the bottom tier of the league.
First one falls for him. Falls, so he hits both of them.
You know, Rondo takes great pleasure at slicing and dicing up the defense. One of the best passers in the game.
Screen by Ellis. Rondo against T. Five on the clock, and here's George for three, and the Pacers can't get it to go.
Just not much success when it comes to shooting.
The shot by Butler, nobody around. And again, Chicago, no good.
And with that miss, shooting only 20% coming out of the break. Ouch.
On the pass to Ellis. Back to George. Young sets a screen for George. Goes back up, and it's sent back by Lopez.
And that is the length of Robin Lopez on display.
Gibson dishes to Butler. Back to Gibson. He kicks to Rondo. They set the pick. Here's Butler. And out of bounds as the Pacers gain possession. At this break in the action, we can show you the teams that had the most rebounds last season. The Bulls third.
Their big man did a tremendous job grabbing rebounds, but to be fair, their rebounding was a total team effort. Everybody chipped in.
Pacers trail by eight. Teague with the ball. It's stolen by Rondo. Butler passes to Lopez. The shot's good on the assist by Butler. Lopez has got 14 points.
And that soft touch of Lopez makes things easy for him down there.
Timeout.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Timeout called the Pacers. Steve, as a player, how often did you go into a situation knowing that you might get a technical foul called on you for saying something to a ref?
You know, a lot of times, Kevin, I went into a referee understanding the game and saying, hey, the momentum right now needs to slow down. Sometimes I get a tech because you kind of have some outbursts. But sometimes I tell the referee, I need a tech right now. Just give me one. Without even really saying anything
wrong. And would they give it to you?
Yeah, sometimes. If not, then I'll just say a few choice words, yes. And then you'll get one.
Good. Tell me that when we get off the air, okay? Thanks. Ellis against Wade. And that's going to be a travel. And a chance now to review the shot chart.
And every time he's pulled up from deep and let it fly, it's found a way to catch iron. Not sure if it is something with his release or the defense is bothering him on his threes, but I would expect him to attack the rim a bit just to kind of mix things up.
Chicago leading by 10. He dishes it to Rondo. He feeds it to Lopez. Let's it go from 14. And stolen by Jeff Teague. Here's Ellis. They grab their own miss. Teague. That one falls. Teague's got 5 points so far.
Well, Jeff Teague is one of the tougher players in the league despite his size, and he did a good job finishing through the contact.
Now here's Rondo. Feeds it to Gibson. Back to Rondo. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. And you look at Jeff Teague, an all-star in 2015, but he's not in that superstar category yet. What does he need to do to get to that level?
You know, it's not one thing. I mean, Teague is good, not great in a lot of areas, and I think he's solidified his place as a starting caliber point guard. I think with his athleticism, he could be an even better defender, which I think is an emphasis here with the Pacers.
So an entirely new group in now for Indiana. Jefferson's checked in for Miles Turner. C.J. Miles comes in for George. Rodney Stuckey's checked in for Ellis. And it's Brooks in for T. Chicago also making some changes. Bobby Portis is checked in for Lopez. Mirotić comes in for Taj Gibson. And Michael Carter-Williams subbed in for Dwayne Wade. And the second free throw, good. Pacers trail by 9. Brooks kicks to Stuckey. Back to Brooks, unloads from 9, lands soft on the front of the rim and drops. He's got 8.
And when it comes to size, it's not a one-on-one matchup that favors him.
Size is only one factor, and it wasn't nearly enough on that possession.
Now here's Rondo. He has 5. Pass to Mirotić. Basket is good. The assist from Rondo. Rondo's got his 7th assist here tonight.
The long arms of Mirotić. When he's got a good chance to shoot down inside, he's always going to take it.
Here's Stuckey. 7 points in the game. Six on the shot clock. Here's Miles. And again, it's Indiana.
That's exactly where they want the ball to go. He did a great job getting the ball into that position.
Now here's Rondo, defended by Miles. Rondo dishes to Butler. Oh, and the jam by Butler.
The burst of athleticism of Butler is fun to watch. He is a tenacious dunker.
Pacers trail by 9. And here is Stuckey. Over to the left wing. Here's Miles. Mirotić grabs the miss. Mirotić has got his 3rd rebound tonight.
A good job by him on the glass here tonight. Plus 8 in that department.
And Jefferson sends it back. But they recover it.
And that's a pure hustle play, getting to the offensive glass for the tip-in.
And that's the kind of quality you see in any strong offensive rebounder, isn't it? Brooks, the pass to Stuckey. Back to Brooks. It's stolen by Rondo. To the middle. Fast break. Here they come. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot 2.
And the European Mirotić very crafty in terms of how he draws fouls. Nikola Mirotić is one of those guys you're waiting and waiting for to break out. He's a stretch 4 that can really knock down a lot of threes. He can be dangerous. We just wait for him to have that breakout season.
First free throw is good. And with Mirotić, the potential is definitely there, Steve. He has a great shot and looked a lot more comfortable, I thought, in the games he started.
You know, the reason why is because the attention is not on him. When you're playing with the starters, you're like the forgotten guy. So he can sneak in, trail, and knock down threes.
The Pacers making a change here. Allen's checked in. And so Mirotić nails both of them. Pacers trail by 13. Brooks outside. Stuckey, a screen on Carter-Williams. Poked away. It's stolen by Carter-Williams. And now the fast break. Grant with the ball. Kept alive. And Mirotić kicks to Carter-Williams. Back to Mirotić. Inside. A second chance effort. And Carter-Williams gets it to go on the assist from Mirotić. And 11 points for Michael Carter-Williams. Rodney Stuckey on the wing. Allen with the screen for Stuckey. Back to Brooks. Can they get it? Mirotić grabs the miss. Mirotić has got 6 rebounds in the game.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
Now here's Brooks. He's got eight. Another shot. And Allen with the layup. Allen's got his second bucket of the game to go.
He is simply one of the best offensive rebounders in the league. He never quits on the glass.
Carter Williams dishes to Grant. Back to Carter Williams. And stolen by Stuckey. Brooks with it. Now defended by Grant. Brooks against Grant. Count that one. The Bulls' lead has been cut to just 11 on the basket from Brooks.
When you get close to the basket like that, good things usually happen.
Grant kicks to Portis. Back to Grant. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. That's on Aaron Brooks. He makes the first. He doesn't get the second one. Pacers trail by 12. Stolen by Grant. 3-on-3. Right wing. Plenty of space. And that's good for two. Grant's got 11 points. Indiana's gotten 1 of 6 three-pointers to drop since coming out of the locker room at halftime. And Miles gets to Allen. Brooks, the best of Stuckey. Back to Brooks. Fires the three. And it's Chicago with the rebound. Portis has got 4 rebounds in this game.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A +10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
The Pacers shooting for the game at 42%. In the corner, Stuckey with it. Trying his luck deep. Chicago grabs the miss. They led by as many as 18 points. McDermott dishes to Mirotić. Takes the bucket. Now he's got 5 field goals, 5 for 8 in the game.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Now here's Stuckey. 7 points in the game. The drive by Brooks. Teardrop shot. Second shot opportunity. And it's blocked by Mirotić. Grant kicks to Mirotić. Here's Portis. That one doesn't go. And Indiana will come the other way. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Brooks kicks to Stuckey. Dishes it to Jefferson. And the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim. 7 points in the game.
Yeah, it's just a smart shot taking advantage of the mismatch.
That's his shot. And with his size, even the defense up on him, they're still not going to be able to block it.
Mirotić has a wide open look. And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. Bulls lead by 14. And after a quick break, we're going to come right back with the start of the fourth quarter. And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know. Pacers trail by 14. So for Chicago right now, at small forward and power forward, it's McDermott and Gibson. Grant is out there with Dwayne Wade. And it's Lopez in at the five down low.
Right now, he's trying to find the mark. Unfortunately, he's starting to feel a little bit desperate.
Grant the pass to Wade. Lopez a screen. Wade kicks to Lopez. Shot clock at five. Here's Grant. Off target from three-point range. And for the Pacers, they're shooting around 40% from the floor here. And Teague has it in the corner. Turner with the screen. Back to Ellis. Looking to get back on track here. And they force the shot clock violation. Great D. Young's checked in for Indiana. Chicago also making some changes. Jimmy Butler comes in for McDermott. Rajon Rondo is subbed in for Jaren Grant. Chicago leading by 14. Right side Rondo. Wade dishes to Lopez. Back to Wade. Outside for Rondo. The three. Kept alive. Here's Gibson. And it's Gibson finishing it off.
That's the kind of energy Gibson gives you, destroying opponents on the glass. Tough to box this guy out.
Guys, we've seen a lot of turnovers in this one.
Yeah, focus, focus, focus. Just make the simple play.
T kicks to Young. Gibson with the steal. And here we go. Rondo heading to the hoop. Here's Wade. Basket is good. The assist from Rondo. Rondo's got his ninth assist in the game now.
Excellent work there in transition.
He doesn't give the defense any time to set up. He just goes extremely hard to the bucket.
Now here's Teague, and Turner kicks to George. They set the pick. Six to shoot, and stolen by Butler. Inside, and here they come. And Lopez throws it down.
When Butler is locked in on a defensive end, his defensive instincts are awesome.
Pacers trail by 20. Fourth quarter of play, and we're about 2.5 minutes through it right now. George against Wade. And George kicks to T. No good off the front iron.
The defense knows he loves that in-between area and closed out fast.
Butler, no good.
You love the closed out on that possession.
I love it because you don't give up on the play. Just that little contest bothered his shot.
And it's Teague, that time on the assist for Monte Ellis. 8 points for Jeff Teague. The Bulls leading by 17. And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. Rondo kicks to Lopez. The feed now to Wade. He watches it go through the hoop for his eighth make. Now 8 for 14.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
And Turner kicks to Ellis. It's hauled in by the Bulls.
He is just really almost playing for the other team. The shooting has just been poor.
Here's Butler. And there's the foul. Goes on Taj Gibson. That's his third foul of the game. Pacers trail by 19. George passes to Young. Can't hit the free throw line jumper. The Bulls have gone 4 of 8 in this fourth quarter, shooting an even 50% from the field. And now the fast break. George with the...
And that's the classic 1-2 punch right there. I mean, nice steal. And then how about the elevation, Kevin, on the finish?
And, Greg, nothing spurs some quick offense like a great play defensively.
When your defense translates into offense, it's a beautiful thing.
And the highlight reel replay brought to you by Kia. Good stuff on that Kia Slam Cam. Now here's Teague. Jimmy Butler unable to get his last shot to go. Nailed from three-point land.
There it is. Just lined it up and knocked it down. His first three of the half, second of the game.
Misses off the right iron.
Something seems off with him tonight. Maybe it's his rhythm or his timing. Fortunately, his teammates are playing well enough to keep them ahead.
Now Wade. Here's Butler. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
One shot.
You know what? This is a skill set to be able to take the bump and stay on balance after the initial contact.
Free throw, good, Butler. Pacers trail by 17. Teague with the ball. Butler covering. Teague kicks to Turner. Tries again. And goaltending is going to be the call. So they get the basket there anyway.
Yeah, you got to like the aggressive D going for the block. But he got it just as it was on its way down.
The Bulls leading by 15. Outside, Rondo passes to Lopez. Outside, Rondo. There's the dish to Gibson. Just five to shoot. Outside for Rondo. And that one comes up a bit short.
And it's just one of those days, guys. He has just struggled to shoot the basketball.
Ellis can't get it to go.
Almost no chance of that shot going in.
On that play, you gotta trust your teammates. Instead of forcing that one, just pass it.
That free throw, no good. He hits the second from the line. Pacers trail by 16. Outside Teague. Ellis left side. Kicks it to Turner. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. He'll shoot one more at the free throw line.
And he just big boyed it right there. The height advantage he's got down low. Really difficult for them to defend.
Here's Rondo. Pass to Lopez. He kicks it to Wade. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Nobody in the league does a better job of selling a pump fake than Wade.
First free throw is good. Both free throws good from Wade. Pacers trail by 15. George dishes to Teague. Outside, George. Back to Teague. Clock at six. From the corner. He can't hit that time. Great D that time from Rondo. Chicago leading by 15. Lopez, a screen on Teague. Butler kicks to Lopez. And the dunk by Lopez.
A beautiful ball movement by Jimmy Butler, constantly looking to set up his guys.
Ellis outside. Indiana moving the ball around. Wade against George. Young for three. The shot's good on the assist by George. That's 12 points for Thaddeus Young. Bulls have gone 6-13, so just above 46% on their field goal attempts here in the quarter. Rondo kicks to Lopez. Butler against George. And slam dunk by Butler.
And when the score is as lopsided as it is, and you can see they smell blood in the water, my man is going for the jugular.
Now here's Teague. Young sets a screen for Ellis. And there's a foul. It goes on Jimmy Butler. That will get him his fourth foul of the game.
That's his fourth foul of the evening. He needs to be careful now. Pick and choose where to be aggressive.
Jefferson's checked in for Miles Turner. Here's Jefferson, and it's sent back by Lopez. And so the ball goes out of bounds. Lopez touched it last. Here's George. Chicago grabs the miss. Lopez has got his 16th rebound on the night. Butler kicks to Gibson. And it's Gibson finishing it off.
What power from Taj Gibson. He really likes sending a message to the defense with his dunks.
Pacers trail by 18. To the paint. And Young with the basket on the assist by George. George has got 5 assists tonight.
Terrific court awareness to hit his teammate with a perfect pass in transition.
Now here's Rondo. And there's the whistle, fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. That's on Jeff Teague. The first one falls. And Rondo drops them both. Pacers trail by 18. T kicks to Young. Outside Teague. Here's Jefferson. Good D by Lopez.
Okay, that lay-in. He's tricky, but the defense was just too tight on him.
Paul George with the steal. And out of bounds as the Bulls gain possession.
That would have been a good time to just keep it simple. No need to rush that pass.
The Bulls leading by 18. Rondo kicks to Gibson. Gibson the screen. And it's Wade in the corner. This one for three. The shot's good on the assist by Butler. Butler's got his fourth assist in this one.
There's something to be said about putting a team on your back, trying to will it to victory. His scoring has been phenomenal this quarter.
And the Bulls with possession. They're on a 13-5 run. There's the pass to Gibson. There's the screen. 5 to shoot. Gibson setting a pick for Wade. Here's Butler. It's rebounded by Indiana.
Well, no one's scoring off that screen. That was terrible.
Well, the league last summer decided to implement new rules, Steve, to discourage the hack-a-shack intentional fouling. What'd you think?
You know what I like, Kevin, to see if we can get to a number during all quarters.
Time
if
out.
You get to a number, say 15 team fouls. After that, no matter who it is,
is two shots and the ball. I think that will limit the Hackershack rule.
Possession would be a big factor in that, wouldn't it?
Yes.
D-Wade really playing well in this one.
Remarkable scoring display that he's putting on. They have to regroup, stop the momentum. Plain and simple, they have to cool him off for a couple minutes. One strategy they might employ is to force him to work hard on the defensive end and to try and sap some of his energy.
Ball's knocked loose. Ellis, the pass to Teague. To the inside. Lopez with the steal. Butler on the wing. Unloads. A basket good off the assist from Wade. Butler's got 7 points here in this quarter.
No waste of time on that catch and shoot. Pretty much nothing you can do if it gets it off that quick.
Timeout called, the Pacers. Well, there have always been big markets and smaller markets in the NBA, but it seems, Steve, that the league has found a proper balance to give small markets or mid-markets a chance every year to succeed.
Yeah, I think so. I think players are doing a nice job right now in free agency. A lot of these guys are going to smaller markets, and when they're there, they're not changing. They're not running for the big lights anymore. So we kind of have somewhat of a balance right now, Kevin.
Like LaMarcus Aldridge comes to mind. Could have gone to Los Angeles, wanted to. The Lakers wanted him badly. He chose a smaller market like San Antonio. Now, granted, a historically good franchise, but a smaller market.
Yeah, and I think guys are doing that. I think it's more about winning versus where you're playing and where you're staying.
Here's Jefferson. Jimmy Butler making his last shot. T kicks to Ellis. Can they get it? Bounces high off the rim and drops.
And Teague knew that he would be open there. Great patience and vision from the point man.
Chicago calls timeout. They're up by 21. 1:52 left in the fourth quarter. Well, Greg, Monte Ellis, one of the most dangerous and prolific slashers in the league.
Yeah, at just 6'3", he's still a terrific athlete and a dynamic finisher at that size. Ellis needs the ball, though, in his hands to be most effective because he can make things happen.
So an entirely new group in now for Indiana. LaVoy Allen's checked in for Young. C.J. Miles comes in for George. Rodney Stuckey's checked in for Ellis. And it's Brooks in for Teague. Portis, the pass to Mirotić. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. Pacers trail by 21. And here's Miles outside. Mirotić grabs the miss. Mirotić has got rebound number 7 for him tonight. Now, here's Grant. Pass to Portis. Here's Carter Williams. Just 5 on the clock. McDermott can't get it to go. Indiana's gotten 3 of their 6 three-pointers to fall here in the fourth.
And one team is just completely outclassing the other tonight. Spirited performance, and it really ignited what is turning out to be a monster win here for the Bulls.
Great, generous ball movement tonight. A thing of beauty.
Yeah, a remarkable team effort. They got everyone involved.
And it'll mark their 4th win on the year. Actually, their 5th win on the year.
And as we get set to put this one to bed, a one-sided season series thus far, they've won 2 straight. And what a huge standout performance it was for Lopez.
It was a big brand of defense he played around the basket, and guys were having all sorts of trouble getting shots over him. All his blocks ended up being a deciding factor in this win.
And so here is Indiana, the Bulls getting the bucket. Stuckey kicks to Brooks. 30 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Jefferson. Chicago with the ball. They're on a 19-7 run. Feeds to Carter Williams. To the middle. finished off by McDermott.
That one will seal the deal there. They've exploded here at the end.
A right time to start playing the best basketball that you can play. They are making everything right now.
On the wing, Stuckey. Jefferson, a screen on Carter Williams. And so Chicago takes this one, and by a big margin. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks a lot, Kevin. Dwayne, congrats on the win. Did you feel tonight like you needed to take over a little bit more than usual?
Well, when you're on the basketball floor, you got to do something. You got to make an impact. And I just try to make an impact either way. So our guys did a great job. That's what it's all about right now.
They took their cue from you, Dwayne. Thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Steve Smith, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. Now time to send you over to the award-winning Ernie Johnson for the postgame show with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith.
The 2K Sports postgame show.
Hey, everybody. Ernie Johnson, along with Kenny Smith and Shaquille O'Neal, seen here. Welcome back for the presentation of our Jordan Player of the Game. Robin Lopez.
He took it upon himself to dominate the glass tonight, fellas, and that's exactly what he did. He finished with a grand total of 19 rebounds. With him out there working as hard as he was on the glass, his teammates had to fall in line.
It's amazing how often he was able to slash right through the defense and get to the rim for an easy deuce. Come on, man. They couldn't stop his penetration, Ernie. All those points he racked up from the paint made a big difference.
And that'll do it for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. For Kenny Smith, for Shaquille O'Neal, for Kevin Harlan, and for the entire 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson. I hope you have a wonderful, even beyond wonderful, a spectacular, just great. I mean, see you.
Good night.